Hi friends, today we'll discuss about the karyotyping. Before going to the karyotyping, I'll give a small idea about the chromosomes. There are 12 pairs of autosomes and 1 pair of allosomes will be there in each cell. Here in this picture, we'll see the arrangement of chromosomes according to the Denmark classification. What we'll see in the Denmark classification, the chromosomes will be arranged according to their length and position of the centromere. So now we'll see the current topic, karyotyping. So, before going to that topic, you have to know about what is meant by the karyotype. Here, the karyotype is a chromosomal representation of an individual is known as a karyotype. In another words, we can say a photomicrographic representation of an individual chromosome which are arranged in a standardized manner is also known as karyotyping. Here, we'll see the photographs will be taken under the microscope, and then after taking that photograph, we'll cut that photograph. In that photograph, we'll see number of chromosomes will be there. So we'll cut that chromosomes and will be arranged, and we will arrange that chromosomes in certain manner. So that is the karyotyping. What will be the uses? We have to know about the uses of this karyotyping. This, by knowing the karyotyping procedure, it will be useful to see the karyotype of an every individual. So this karyotype is helpful for knowing structural and numerical aberrations of a chromosome. Karyotype is helpful to identify the structure and number of chromosome. Now we'll see the procedure of karyotyping. That is, first we have to collect the 5 ml of venous blood. Here there is a flow chart for that one. To attain that karyotype, there is one procedure. That procedure is known as a karyotyping. First, we have to take the 5 ml of venous blood, which will be mixed with the heparin. Here, heparin will act as an anticoagulant, which prevents the blood from clotting. And then place that blood in a centrifuge. After keeping that in a centrifuge, these lymphocytes will separate it from the RBC. So these white blood cells are separated from RBC, and then we'll take that white cell suspension in a vial. Vial is nothing but a small container having fetal calf serum. So we'll collect that lymphocytes from the RBC. We'll place that white cell suspension in a vial. Here vial is a container having fetal calf serum and phytoagglutinin. Here fetal calf serum will act as a culture media. Culture media, this provides a nourishment to the lymphocytes. And then phytoagglutinin, what if we see the function of this phytoagglutinin is, it stimulates the cell division. And then we'll add antibiotics. What will antibiotics do means, here this antibiotics will prevent the culture from infection. Okay, so after that we'll place this culture vial in an incubator for 3 days at 37 degree centigrade. At this stage, the cells will repeatedly undergo divisions. After completion of the 3 days, we'll remove that vial, we'll take out that vial, and we have to add colchicine. Here, this function of this colchicine is mainly prevention of cell division at the stage of metaphase. And then another function is, it prevents the formation of spindle fibers. After that, we'll take that metaphasic stage of chromosomes, and then we'll add hypotonic saline to that cells. By adding this hypotonic saline, here the cells will swell up and they are separated. At this stage, we can identify the chromosomes. For this suspension, we have to add a glacial acetic acid and methanol. Here, this glacial acetic acid and methanol will act as a fixatives. The main function of this glacial acetic acid and methanol is to fix the cells. After that fixation, we have to take one drop of that solution, and from certain height, you put a drop on a chilled slide. By pouring a drop from certain height, there is an use. What is that use means? From certain height, if we pour a drop on the chilled slide, the cell will break up its cell wall and these chromosomes will spread at that metaphase stage. So here we call it as a metaphasic spread. So the chilled slide containing the metaphase spread will be stained. Some stains will be there. We'll stain that slide and we'll take some photographs under the microscope. So after getting the photograph, the individual chromosome, In that photograph, we'll cut that chromosome and we'll arrange according to the length of the chromosome, as we know from A to G groups. And the karyotype of a person will be obtained here. This is the procedure to attain the karyotype, and this procedure is known as a karyotyping. This completes the session. Thank you.